The next step in our quest to understand the Sunset Crater eruption is to understand what happened during the eruption within the plumbing system itself. Sunset Crater is part of the San Francisco volcanic field that has an extensive plumbing system. Volcanologists use magma fossils, or frozen bits of the melt, to understand the explosive fuel of the eruption. How can something so small tell us so much about something so big? Well, before the volcano erupts, the magma travels up the vertical column that feeds the volcano. As this happens, tiny blobs of melt, smaller than the diameter of a human hair, are trapped in crystals that grow in the magma. These blobs are called melt inclusions. Why call them fossils? Because these melt inclusions consist of gas and small amounts of hot magma that are quenched, sort of like being frozen, within a tiny crystal at different depths and times during the course of the eruption. These tiny packets of information record the composition of the magma and the gas content in the magma as the volcano erupts. When the magma travels up toward the surface, the gases expand and drive the explosive power of a volcanic eruption, much like the pressurized fizzy gas of soda that has been shaken and exposed to the air. The melt inclusions from Sunset record a high amount of carbon dioxide gas, and that gas is one of the reasons that the pulsed eruption was so explosive. But research always prompts new questions. And one of the next questions is, why exactly did this magma have so much carbon dioxide? We think it may have something to do with the region deep in the Earth's crust where that magma formed. Please stay tuned for more answers.